Welcome inside Dodger Stadium here in Los Angeles. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Houston Astros.
And now, your 2021.
We've got baseball on Houston. The show, and it's coming up next.
Astros.
Ready now is Brandon Lau, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Comes at him with the slider there, and he gets the strike. Our temperature 74 degrees as we get things started this afternoon. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game. One out, base is empty, and in to swing the bat next is Wander Franco. And he'll come back with one in the third as the count moves to 2-1 now.
The offensive game plan today is certainly to see the ball up. This guy is known on the mound for sinker changeup combination. He's going to try and establish down in the zone to get swing and a miss or ground balls consistently. You have to find something above the belt to get loose on.
3-2 now. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And that brings up the corner infielder, G-Man Choi. 1-1. He's outside for a ball. Just underway here in Southern California. To 2-2 now.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. Here comes the second baseman, Jose Altuve, to get things kicked off in the home half of inning number one. The 1-1. Line toward right center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Batting second, the left fielder, Michael Brantley.
At the plate now, Michael Brantley lifted the other way to left center. Meadows has it, and there's one away. And that'll bring up Alex Bregman. First swings for him in this one, with the runner still at first and one gone.
Bregman.
The 1-1 home. Takes this the other way to right, and that'll get down for a base hit. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
That is cool. The designated hitter, Yordan.
So now to the plate, Yordan Alvarez. And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. Ball three. 3-2 now. Yuli Gurriel waits on deck. Lifted the other way down the left field line. Meadows is over now, and he puts this one away in foul territory, and there are two men out. So two on with two away, and digging in to bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. The 1-1. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Kiermaier on the run. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. New inning set to get underway, and standing in is the DH, Nelson Cruz. The 1-1 home. Is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. No one on with one down, and Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. Swing and a miss on the pitch outside. 1-2 now.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch outs and working on number five.
And they'll just tag him out along the first base line. Next to hit is Randy Arozarena. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Now the 1-1 pitch. Strike two swinging.
One ball, two strikes.
That front door slider is a devastating pitch. By the time you realize it's in the zone, it's too late. You can't even put a good swing on it.
Count even at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. To short. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and stepping up as the shortstop, Carlos Correa. He squares this one nicely, and it's lined into center field for a leadoff single.
That is tough. The right fielder, Kyle.
In now, Kyle Tucker. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Meadows will settle under it to make the play for the first out, as the runner will have to head back to first. Stepping in next, Chaz McCormick.
The center fielder, Chaz McCormick.
Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Looked like that one tied him up a bit. A swing and a miss. And it's fouled away. Correa leads off first with one away.
Nope,
a little low. It's 2-2. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now. 3-2.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
Batting down, the catcher, Martin.
Stepping in now, Martin Maldonado. And this one's in the dirt. The runners will hold tight, but it's a full count now, 3-2. High and deep to left center field. Meadows moving back, still ranging back. Gone! At the plate, Jose Altuve. 2-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Swing and a flare hit toward right. Here comes the right fielder. He can't get there as it falls in.
The left fielder, number 23, Michael Brantley.
Into the box now, Michael Brantley.
Well, that's off.
Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1.
Well, I think he just kind of lost focus on the mound right there. It's clearly not going his way, and he's thinking more about that than the task at hand. And right now, he needs to think about this hitter.
Three runs already home here. Grounded back up the middle. There's one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Top of the third set to get underway, and digging in next will be Joey Wendell.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
Count is 1-2 now. And this will be fouled away.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Got him to go down swinging there. Joey Wendell goes down for the first out here in inning number 3. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. So two are gone here in the Tampa Bay third inning, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. And it's a ball and two strikes to Kiermaier now.
He's one pitch away from striking out the side, but even more than that, to throw a donut up after your offense put up some runs, I can't tell you what that means to the boys in the dugout.
And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. And now in the box, Alex Bregman. He collected a base hit his first time up. Now the 2-1 pitch. Left side, reined in. Throw on to first, and one third baseman grounds out to the other, one away. Now at the plate here is Yordan Alvarez. That's lifted the other way out to left. He takes the turn and heads for second. And that will hop over the wall now as he'll be awarded second base here. It's a ground rule double. At the plate now,
Yuli Gurriel.
Hit back up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. And he's out. Beautiful throw home to cut down the run. Standing in now, Carlos Correa. Full count still. Here comes the payoff pitch. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Swing and a liner. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Again, another foul ball. Gurriel leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. This is flared out towards second. Over to first, and that retires the side. So stepping in is Brandon Lau. He'll lead it off against Lance McCullers. Now the 3-2 pitch. And he lays off there. Ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Now
that brings up Wander Franco. Too much dip on the sinker. Laid off for a ball. Tried to bury one down and away, but it's full count now, 3-2.
This is the kind of pitching that's frustrating for me to watch. He had him down 0-2, then he started getting cute, and now the count is full at 3-2. It happens, but I'd rather see him attack the hitter and force contact.
And now this is thrown wildly, just getting it into the infield.
Now that the first baseman.
So now to the plate, G-Man Choi. This is hit sharply to the left side. And this ought to play the couple as this ball's down for extra bases.
Now back, the designated hitter, Nelson Cruz.
Into the box, Nelson Cruz. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Two and two now. No one out with a runner at second. Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Rays DH.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he'll take strike three called, and he needed that one badly on the mound. One away. One home. Waves and misses for strike number two.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Two runs on two hits. And no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Got caught lunging there as this one's fouled away. Still one and two as he fouls it away. From the belt, the pitch. Hard hit towards center. McCormick is there. Two gone. Now into the box. Randy Arozarena trying here to plate the tying run from second. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number nine here, and the side is retired. Of the inning now, and in to hit next will be the outfielder Kyle Tucker. Whoa. Down low, two balls and a strike.
Lots of hits given up, but so far no walks. At least he's making them work to get on base. Problem is, they haven't had to work too hard.
Swing and a liner. And that gets down, and we'll see if that's extra bases. He's through first and hustling for second. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Now back, the seventh fielder.
Stepping in now, Chaz McCormick. And that one yanked just foul. Here now the 2-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So now into the box is Martin Maldonado. And we'll see what he can do here after going deep his first time up. Sliced hard on the ground. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third. So they're runners at the corners now with one away.
The second baseman.
In now, Jose Altuve. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Now a chopper to second. This will be a tough turn. To second for one. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. 0 for 2 on his line thus far.
Michael Brantley.
Is a cutter that misses 2-1.
We're starting to see a lot more balls from him now, and that's a direct result of him getting hit around pretty good. He's trying to do something different, and it's resulting in him not attacking the strike zone anymore.
Set to deal on 2-2. This one's flared off to the right side. In there, the base hit. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
Third baseman, Alex
Bregman. Now, Alex Bregman. Line hard to center field. Kiermaier able to track it down for the third out. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And that'll give way to the third baseman, Joey Wendell. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
All three.
And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning. The 1-1. Wendell aboard here at first with nobody out. And he pulls this one back in time, 2-2. And And they do have him scoring with two strikes as he gets this one down. Throw on to first, so the sacrifice is successful. Next, it'll be Kevin Kiermaier, struck out in his last trip to the plate. 4-2 our score here as we play inning number 5. Hit out towards second. Altuve fields it cleanly, and that's the second out. So Tampa's batting order turns over, set to go. Brandon Lau, runner in scoring position with two gone. To 2-2 now. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over. Josh Fleming, a 6'2" left-hander, jogs in to take over on the hill. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. Grounded sharply, but right at that loaded side of the infield. And there's one down now. Now to the plate here is Yuli Gurriel. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Here's the pitch. Hard hit ball to second. Scooped up. Throw gets him. Two down. Here's Carlos Correa now. 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. Bases are empty here with two men out. 1-1 pitch and a good sinker there, but he can't find the zone. 2-1. Over at the knees, and that's the second strike. Ready on 2 balls and 2 strikes. Here it comes.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. He's under it, and that ends the inning. So now to the plate, Wander Franco singled in his last at bat. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball 4, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the 6th. So the next to bat will be G-Man Choi, 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. Fooled him with that one as he's way out in front.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
3-2, full count. Count remains full. Another full count pitch home. Shot down the line. It's a fair ball. Franco rounds the corner and is headed home. He's in time, and he's cut down at the plate as they team up to gun him down. Yimi Garcia, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound. Into the box now, Nelson Cruz. Lays off a slider that time, 2-1.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at-bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
All even now, 2-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. And the throw to first is there to record the second out. So a runner at second, 2 down now. And Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. The 1-1. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Now a long throw home. But this won't be in time as he's well saved and the run scores. So now to the plate, Randy Arozarena. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. That's in there, and it'll run the count to full, 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Fouled away. Good battle. Count remains full. Meadows is off of first with two away. This pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away. Brooks Raley comes on now, and this move looks to be all about playing the matchup here.
Yeah, and I don't think there's any doubt about that, Matt. They want the lefty-lefty matchup, and that's usually the right move, but we'll just have to see how this plays out.
Right at the third baseman, and that'll end the inning. Of the sixth inning now, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Kyle Tucker. 1-1. Misses up and in.
Count is 2-1. That's ball
3-1.
That's the heavy sinker right there. He has the ability to get ground balls when he needs them, potential double play situations, or to get that jam job with no one on base, that tapper right back to the pitcher. One of the toughest pitches to hit in the game.
The 1-1.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
Ball even at 2-2. Has a look, now the pitch. In the dirt here, and a good idea to hang close at first as he'll make it back easily. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. On the move is Kiermaier. But it's over his head, and it pops the wall for a ground rule double. At the plate, Martin Maldonado. He's got it. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. The 1-2. 5 runs, 12 hits, 1 error so far for the Astros. Hard sinker misses 2-2.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
Sent on the ground out to second. Reined in. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. Here's Michael Brantley. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. Brantley. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Seventh inning ready to roll. Digging in as the big-time power threat, Mike Zunino. A 1-2 count to the Rays catcher. Just hung in there on that one. Here he comes again, 1-2. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Therefore, it is Gurriel, and there's one gone. One out now in the Tampa Bay seventh, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. ready to deliver the 1-2. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. One out, nobody on. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh. Next, here is Brandon Lau. He's 0-2 thus far in this one. Here's the 1-1 delivery.
The count is 2-1.
Yeah, if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch until he proves he can lay off of it.
Whoa, that's
down. Falling behind now, 3-1. And a full count now, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. High fly ball out to straightaway center. McCormick will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. And that'll bring up the former first rounder, Alex Bregman. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Hit the other way out toward right field. Long run for the right fielder. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. Pulled toward right center field. Kiermaier giving chase. He gets there, and that's the second out. Next up, Yuli Gurriel. He grounded out last time up. To him on the mound, and he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. Kendall Graveman has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 31.
And now here is Wander Franco. It was a walk in his last trip. Took a good cut that time, but comes up empty, 2-2.
You got to be paying attention as an offense in a hitter's meeting in this situation. When you got a guy on the mound that you know the bottom can drop out of any pitch he throws, you have to elevate your sights.
He pulls this one into right. And a base hit, so early trouble to lead off the inning.
The batter, the first baseman. G-man.
Into the box, G-Man Choi grounded down the third baseline. Open to send him packing, pitch on its way. Outside and low that time, now it's two balls and two strikes. And he tried to hold up that time. We'll get an appeal down to third, and no swing. It's ball three. Struck him out, so he's set down on strikes for the second time today. Striding forward now is the DH. Nelson Cruz, he went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch-outs will stick with you a little longer.
Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first, and no swing. It's ball two. Now the 2-1. Swung on and missed for strike number two.
He knows full well he's sitting on a hat trick right here. All he's trying to do is avoid the golden sombrero.
Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. From the stretch. And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. Four strikeouts. Ryan Pressly is called upon with two out in the eighth, as he's asked to complete a four-out save. Austin Meadows will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. The 1-1 pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Working for the punch out and the offering. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Carlos Correa. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball 2. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And Lau is there for the catch. There's one gone. Next up for the Astros, Kyle Tucker is working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And he fouls this one off. Bases are empty, one man out. Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. The next 1-2 pitch. That's lifted the other way out to left. Meadows is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out. Okay. Next to dig in, Chaz McCormick. 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. The 1-1. Swung on and missed.
The count is 1-2.
Heading out towards shallow right. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. All set to start the 9th in this one. And at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Randy Arozarena.
They look like they're up against it here. Down 3 on the road, trying to come back against the closer.
And this pitch misses here. It's ball 4, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the 9th.
Now back.
So a runner at first now with nobody out. And digging in next will be Joey Wendell. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Ah gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone. 1-2.
Hey, you know the pitcher right now. He's looking for that best friend, that double play ball. This is where you have to really be disciplined at the plate and make sure that you get a pitch that's above the knees that you can get in the air.
Bregman is there, and he's got it for the first out. Into the box, Mike Zunino, 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. And they'll try and play for 1 here as he gets this one down. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. The 1-1. Swing and a hard liner to center field. McCormick is there now, and he has it, 2 gone. And he'll take those extra 90 feet, so put runners at the corners now with 2 gone in the inning. Now it'll be Brandon Lau. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the 9th. The 1-1 home.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus and making some good pitches.
Fouled off. A crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. Alive here as he gets a piece of this, and in turn he gets a piece of the catcher behind the plate. Tampa down to their final strike in this one. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. High and deep down the left field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Yeah, they needed him a little bit earlier in this one, but he takes the mound in the eighth and records the final four outs. Four out save. Job well done.
6-3, the final score today. The Astros took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Lance McCullers takes home the win. Ryan Yarbrough was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Fans, our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Astros.